Interestingly, 2022 delivered several notable mystery comedies, which I'm certainly not complaining about, and one of them was Tom George's See How They Run. The 1950s set tale sees a boozy, but seasoned police inspector.
How much longer do you intend to hold us all hostage?
Or is that the idea? Gather all the suspects and interrogate each of us in turn until the mystery is solved?
Mad commoners overweight the playwright.
Celebrate it, Vera.
Oh, I'm so sorry, sir. Come read me on handwriting.
There was an incident.
Jackass Forever is expected to be the final installment in the film saga that was spawned by the beloved MTV reality comedy series. And if Pixar graced the public with another classic this year in the form of Turning Red, a coming-of-age tale with a fantastical twist. Set in 2002, the film tells the story of 13-year-old Mei Lin, who, to her horror, discovers that she turns into a giant red panda whenever she's overcome with emotions. Like See How They Run, Nicolas Cage's The Unbearable Weight of Massive Talent is very meta, but that approach works better here. This buddy comedy has Cage playing a fictionalized and down-on-his-luck version of himself who travels to Majorca to attend the birthday of a superfan, Pedro Pascal. Most people probably wouldn't have expected Confess, Fletch, a new installment in the Fletch film franchise, to be one of the year's best comedies, but here we are. This adaptation of Gregory MacDonald's 1976 novel of the same name puts John Hamm in the role of Erwin Maurice Fletcher, and he's perfect. Yes, The Banshees of Inisherin is one of the most depressing movies of the year. However, Martin McDonagh's tale of two friends, Colin Farrell and Brendan Gleeson, includes a generous helping of humor. Some of it comes from Farrell's dull, yet well-meaning, horror, and Gleeson hilariously exudes the musically inclined Colm's annoyance with his former friend's inability to part ways with him.
He's dull, Siobhan.
But he's always been dull.
The other night, 2 hours you spent talking to me about the things you found in your little donkey shite that day.
Well, it wasn't your little donkey shite, it was my pony shite, which shows how much you were listening.
If you don't stop talking to me, if you don't stop talking to me, I have a set of shears at home. Each time you don't bother me from this day on, I'll take those shears and I'll take one of my fingers off of them and I'll give my finger to you. I have no fingers left. Thank you.
sweet swan song for director Roger Michell, The Duke offers a well-acted and engaging dramatization of an entertainingly improbable true story.
Bit of biscuit.
One problem. What's that?